Welcome to Birds of Prey Sports Talk, where we weekly cover Orioles and Ravens news. We're your hosts, Jared and TJ. You guys have no idea how long it took to do that intro. That took like 9-10 attempts because that was our first time doing this. But anyway, in this video, we'll be covering players we're high on after the preseason game and the joint practice. The preseason game, obviously, versus the Eagles, and the joint practice with the Commanders that just happened yesterday. I'm going to pass it on to TJ as he has more players that he's high on than me. Go ahead.
Yeah, so, you know, just to, you know, have some thoughts, you know, about the Ravens versus Eagles game. There's a lot of bad things to point out, you know, but some good.
I knew you were going to say that.
You know, one of the bad things was the secondary. I mean, they were just getting torched the whole game by, you know, nobodies. You know, guys from Shoe City and DTLR, you know, pick up right off the street, you know, it seems like. And so,
yeah, in Philly streets, yeah.
You know, no disrespect to them, but, you know, when you got Brandon Stevens out there, you know, who's had first team reps, you know, that shouldn't be happening to him. So that, you know, that concerns me a little bit, you know, especially if our, you know, secondary being thin this year, you know, and we got to go up against a lot of monster teams like the Seahawks, the Bengals, you know, and whatnot, you know, but a bright spot could be Keaton Mitchell. I mean, he's just like a flash. Like, he's just super fast. You know, he honestly made me forget about J.K. Dobbins for a minute. I'm going to go as far and say that, you know, this guy is good. He's just very explosive. And, you know, I just want to know what your thoughts are about him. Keaton Mitchell.
Sorry, I had to cough a little bit right there. But, no, I mean, I agree with you. You know, you were really high on him when we were watching the preseason game. You know, he had that nice run that got called back for holding later. I think it was in the third quarter. He also had a nice run today in the joint practice, I believe, after Falele did a pancake tackle, I believe. A pancake block. But, yeah, I mean, he looked explosive, you know. Running backs are easy to find, but, like, that's a explosiveness that not every running back has, you know. And he seemed like he had good ball carrier vision, you know, seemed like to get through the holes very well. You know, had just this explosive speed after he got past the offensive line. You know, it was literally like the Flash, you know, like how you said, you know, he just was like here one minute and there next, you know. So I wouldn't mind keeping him, you know, on the roster just because, you know, we know the you know, the terrible injury that J.K. Dobbins had. You know, you never know when he could just want to sit out for some reason. And then, you know, Gus Edwards, you know, he, who knows what could happen to him, you know. And then, you know, it just what happened in 2021 is kind of traumatizing. So it's like, you know, it'd be nice to just have, you know, two running backs like Justice Hill and then Keaton Mitchell on the back end, guys you know are reliable, you know. And then who knows, maybe Keaton Mitchell could be a good special teams guy for now, maybe a punt returner. Well, I mean, maybe not a punt returner because you got Duvernay, but let's say Duvernay goes down, or maybe they want to focus Duvernay more on the offensive side of the ball instead of special teams, then Keaton Mitchell's a great option for that as well. You know, so I think that, you know, I fully agree with you that I want to see him on the roster, and I want to see him get used a little bit, you know. I want to see this offense to be used in different packages, whether it's a passing play or maybe it's a read option, you know, because if you have Lamar and Keaton Mitchell back there, you know, the two elusive and fast guys who pass the offensive line, you know. So, I mean, obviously it's going to be hard for him to get some reps just because you got J.K., Gus, and Hill probably ahead of him. So, but, you know, you never know. Injuries happen in this league. So, and trades happen as well. What if we trade Gus? Doubt that happened. What, trade J.K.? Doubt that happened as well, but you never know. So, we're just going to see.
You know, yeah, I agree wholeheartedly with everything you just said, you know. And, you know, this is a tricky business, you know. The things that you wouldn't expect happen could happen, you know. Right. So, you know, I'd also like to point out the receivers look pretty good in this game too. Tylan Wallace had a great touchdown catch. You know,
Duvernay,
you know, receivers, you know, stepped up. And, you know, Tyler Huntley looked pretty good as well. You know, he's like a preseason, you know, Hall of Famer at this point for the Ravens, you know.
Yeah, if that was the thing, he'd be first ballot. Definitely looks better than he does in the regular season.
You got Jared out here handing participation awards. But, you know, yeah, he looked good, you know. He made You look good
It's
out
like
there.
they, at least you try certificate, you know. Good job, kid. Here's a sticker, you know. Anyway.
He should have got that after the Bengals game, but yeah, anyway,
Yeah. No, he should have gave it to the freaking Bengals fans because he gave away the game. I don't know
Although
what went through his head. You know, we never really got a chance to cover that because we weren't even really filming videos at that point, but we would have been demonetized if that happened when we were filming videos. Like, I just remember. Anyway, go ahead so we don't have to live past our trauma with
but
Brandon Stevens.
just not a very convincing win, for our practice squad players and our rookie players. There's still a lot of, things that, we need to work on, especially with the secondary and with the
Yeah.
offensive line as well. I remember Ben Cleveland just got plowed by Jalen Carter. It was embarrassing, for a rookie, to, like a 3 or 4 year vet, so.
Right, a guy who also is like Jim Irsay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, okay, time out. But so before we continue, I want to say there's a video that I haven't put out yet where you guys won't get the Jim Irsay jokes, and it's probably for a good reason. Anyway, go ahead.
Oh. Those two. You got me messed up with them Jim Irsay jokes, but not a very convincing win. Hopefully, when we play the Commanders, I believe next Tuesday, we could see a little bit better, I just overall, from our team, especially the secondary. We all got the spotlight on you, so you got to show up better.
Yeah.
I guess we can move on now to the joint practice, which Chippy is an understatement. I mean, you have, numerous fights breaking out. Mark Andrews body slamming the guy, Tylan Wallace and Forbes. I think his name was Emmanuel Forbes or
Yeah.
I just remember Forbes, getting into a fight. I think Zay Flowers got into a little bit of a scuffle in practice.
If he did,
Or
I
was
agree
it
with that.
either Zay or OBJ? Just very chippy at the Ravens and Commanders. And do you think this is a good thing or a bad thing, that both teams are getting fired up, just early on in the season?
The way I see it is almost like, can I just ask you something before we continue with this one?
Of course.
Do you ever feel like in this tenure with Lamar Jackson, the Ravens have kind of just been soft?
I feel like in some ways, yes.
Remember, we let the freaking Titans come into our home and like walk on
Yeah.
our logo, and then they come in and beat us in overtime the same way pretty much we lost in the playoff game. I mean, we got our get back, but it's just like, I don't know. It's just, they felt kind of soft. Like they would just let teams like just pull over them, like, and just like little bro them, as you would say, and it's like, I think that with that happening, you don't want to create an image of a team that is unhinged, but it's nice to have a team that would ha it has a chip on the shoulder, where it's like, you're not gonna throw us around and treat us like trash, like we're gonna get in your face and we're gonna yell at you, and you're like, maybe we're gonna start a fight or two. It's just, obviously you don't want fights to start happening in the middle of the game because you don't want players getting ejected. But I mean, it's nice to know that. I mean, and then to mention, Tylan Wallace got in the fight with Emmanuel Forbes, I believe, and then DuVernay comes in and body slams him and then chokes him out. So it's like, yeah, probably wouldn't want that to happen in a game, but it's nice to have team chemistry where guys are going to want to fight for each other, So I like it. It's concerning in a way, but I like it at the same time, in a way of like, we're not going to be soft. I don't want to be soft.
Yeah.
I'm getting tired of that. It feels like back then the Ravens were never soft. It's like they had guys who could take your head off, But now it's like, we're scared, but not scared, but just guys who, and they're probably not soft. It probably could be a better term used, but it felt that way watching it, and it's like, I think with the addition of Roquan last season, You know, I mean, think about it when the Bengals game last year got chippy. You know, like that felt like Ravens football when that defense was playing out there. You know, they were like, I'm just gonna say they were bitching around the young guys in the game. You know, like, and then they had Ja'Marr Chase crying to the media after Roquan Smith bumped into him in that one play. It's like, I don't know, you can do a lot of talking, but you can't handle a simple bump. So it's like, you know, be a man and just play some football. You know, so it's like, it's not like Roquan just like, you know, choked him out and threw him over the wall. You know, it just was a simple like bump, like get out of the way, get into my teammate. So it's like, you know, I mean, I kind of like that, you know, bring the chippiness back in the AFC North if you want to see it. You know, it's like, remember those old Ravens and Steelers matchups? Like someone was guaranteed to be put in the hospital, you know, in that game, you know, I don't want like players to get hurt. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying like, Let's get the Ravens back to being tough.
Yeah. You know, and I agree. You know, there's been teams, you know, like the Chiefs and the Titans that have, you know, really been talking trash about us the past couple of years. Very disrespectful at it too. You know, and it's nice to see us, you know, getting the identity of being tough again, you know, and not soft. Because, you know, soft is one word that cannot be used along the same like the same sentence as Baltimore, you know.
Right.
Soft cannot be used, you know. So I like it too. I like it too, you know. And I feel like I feel like Lamar, you know, I see him in some videos, you know, talking a little bit to players sometimes, you know. Lamar likes to talk back sometimes on the field, you know. And I like that too, you know, and our team is behind them as well. You know, they'll never let nothing happen to Lamar.
Right.
So, you know, I agree. You know, we need to get our identity back as being tough, hard-nosed team. And we're fighting for each other. You know? But I'm just curious how this is going to translate into the game. You know, like, what are your predictions for the game?
The Commanders game?
Yeah.
I think it's just going to be – I mean, we're probably going to win, you know, if I had to be honest, you know. And you know, it'll probably translate to some hurt feelings. Like Emmanuel Forbes, a first-round draft pick, I believe. Mm-hmm. He might want to get in some of the receivers' faces. He might want to get on Tylan Wallace. He might not want to take that disrespect. So all we got to do is just hurt his feelings even more, you know, even if it's just a preseason game. So it's like, I mean, it might translate to some chippiness in the game, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's kind of how I predict it. Now, personally, I wouldn't want to play in that hellhole of a field that – almost ended J.K. Dobbins' career. I'd rather have that stadium, you know, demolished, in my opinion, and they play somewhere else. Play at Nats Park for all I care. But it's like, I don't know. I'm worried about playing in that stadium. You know, that stadium has a lot of bad memories on it from Alex Smith. Was it Joe Theismann who got hurt there?
Yeah.
RG3.
You went back old time, Joe Theismann. I didn't even think about that.
And then J.K. Dobbins, like, they had that freaking curse where they had us losing Marcus Peters and then Gus Edwards. Like,
yeah.
Anyway, so you get the point.
Yeah. like, you know, to, you know, piggyback off what you were talking about, I feel like we win too, you know. I feel like it will be a better outing, especially from our defense, you know. We should lock down those receivers. I mean, if Gary Terry McLaurin is playing, you know, then that's one thing, even though I don't think he will. But, you know, we should expect to see a better defensive outing, you know.
Yeah.
I know that some of those guys aren't going to go out like that, you know, how that Eagles game went, you know, just getting bodied by, you know, downtown locker room workers, you know. So, you know, we just have to do better. You know, I'm serious. I'm being serious. I'm not trying to be funny here, but, you know, those guys really work at Subway. So, you know, we just...
All right, man. You don't got to...
All right.
You don't got to keep roasting them. They're going to come after us next.
I just want to
make us a sandwich. Give me some shoes. I'll make it worse.
You know, your job? I'm just playing. But, you know, yeah. You know, both of us here at Birds of Prey, we expect better, you know, from them against the Commanders. And, you know, we'll be doing live updates. We'll definitely be letting you guys, you know about our opinions, you know, and how we feel, you know. And
we might be at the game, won't we? Not the Commanders game, but the Orioles game, right?
On the 21st. Yeah, we
Yeah.
will.
Well, 21st, it's a Monday, isn't it?
Yes.
All right, so we won't be at the game. We'll be watching the game.
Oh, the 22nd, yeah. You know, but you know, before we end this video, I would just give up my three most anticipated players for the Commander series. And you know, once again, Keaton Marshall. I'm excited to see, you know, how he builds off of, you know, his performance against the Eagles and also what he's been doing.
You mean Keaton Mitchell? You say Marshall.
Keaton Mitchell. You know, I'd just be excited to see, you know, how he builds off his performance against the Eagles and, you know, what he's been doing in the you know, combined practices so far against the Commanders. I say my second one is definitely Brandon Stevens. You know, he needs to get his reputation back, you know, after that game against the Eagles. You know, I don't think he'll want to go out like that. So I expect him to be much more, you know, tighter, much more better in coverage, you know, making better reads. Because he could potentially be, you know, a starter, you know, in our secondary this year. So I expect more out of him.
Yeah.
So maybe this one is unusual, but I expect better from Ben Cleveland. You know, he got blew past him, you know, blew past him, you know, by Jalen Carter, which he was arguably one of the best players in the draft, but you can't just let rookies, you know, blow past you like that. You know,
Well,
you gotta put
you know Jalen Carter's, you know, used to blowing past things, you know, like
No, no,
speed
no,
limit,
no, no, don't
like
do it.
speed, like speed limits.
I knew he was gonna go there. I knew he was.
Anyway.
You know, I just expect him to be much more tighter, you know, when, you know, protecting the QB.
Yeah. And I agree.
Definitely.
You know, my breakout players are probably like if they start, I want to see Oweh get some pressure. You know, he was dominating in the, you know, joint practice. So I want to see him get some pressure in and you know, maybe sack the quarterback a few times. Keaton Mitchell. I think Keaton Mitchell has a roster spot locked up. He shouldn't even be playing. But if he does, I want to see him perform. Same thing with Brandon Stevens. I want to see Darryl Worley perform as well. You know, I want to see him out there performing. I want to see Ojabo out there doing good. But and another one I want to see do good. It might be also unusual, but I want to see Anthony Brown do better.
Oh,
He
yeah.
was terrible in that preseason game, man. He was terrible. He almost gave away the game. You know, obviously you want to carry maybe two or three quarterbacks, two quarterbacks as backups, one quarterback as a starter, obviously. But Josh Johnson was terrible in that game. He's not QB3. He's not even QB4. God forbid if he's QB5. Anthony Brown needs to do better, you know, or we're gonna have a struggle to find our QB3, you know, and Anthony Brown most likely won't make the team, but I want to see something better from him. You know, he like I said, he was terrible in that game, you know, and there was a lot not good about that Eagles game. There was a lot good, there wasn't a lot good, you know. I'm proud of our defense for, you know, only really allowing the 13 points, you know, and then stopping them with a 2-point conversion. They seem to get it together. And a lot of this is probably just jitters and then, you know, maybe you know, first game rust and fatigue or whatever, but hopefully the second game will be a little bit better. You know, I mean, we're not expecting too much just because it is a preseason game. Like we're probably not going to do recaps of the games. You know, we're just going to do like small little videos like this, talking about like our breakout players. And if you guys want to see it, maybe we'll do a 53 man roster, video prediction, seeing who's going to make the team, who's not. And, I'm going to me and TJ will talk behind the scenes, see if you want to do that. Do you have anything else to add here?
I don't know. We got everything.
All right. Well, so just want to let you guys know TJ will be overseas, so videos will be a little bit delayed until next week. So expect the content to come out, you know, tomorrow. There should be two videos coming out, and then maybe one on Thursday. So, but keep TJ's in your wishes, keep him safe. You know, so I'm gonna say it here to you since this is probably the last time I'm seeing you until next week. So hope you stay safe, bro.
Thank
And
you.
everything goes well. So you have nothing else to add?
You know, just you know, we got much more content coming. You know, we're hungry, we know, to get it out to you guys, and you know, just
Right.
expect much more.
Right. So when TJ gets back, and so full force after that, the season will be this Orioles season will be full postseason push. and the Ravens season will be full, you know, regular season push, you know, as well. So to look, just be on the lookout, TikToks, Twitter, and all that. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Share on TikTok, Instagram, wherever you can. Make sure to check out our second. Make sure to check out our Twitter. You know, where we're gonna post live updates in the preseason game and Orioles games. Make sure to check out our TikTok. We have a few TikToks up there already. I almost messed it up. don't forget to subscribe to our second channel, Casual Cinema. We always promise we have content coming there, but we never do. We never put anything on there. But we promise eventually there'll be something up there. So just make sure you sub to that one. It might be a little bit harder with the writer strike and whatever, but we're just going to have to see. You know, and we're Birds of Prey, and we're out.
We're out.